Welcome to today's video, and today we are doing really easy, simple and bright Korean makeup look for beginners. And for this you can use any type of makeup you have at your home, and I have total 10 steps to show you. So if you are really interested in this cute bright Korean makeup look, so let's go ahead and start with step 1. But first let me remove my bangs from my face first. Step 1 is makeup base, and for this you can use any type of makeup base, makeup primer, for brightening, for color correction and for visible pores. Here I am using Innisfree No Sebum Blur Primer only on areas where I have visible pores, and to get a smooth base for next step. Step 2 is foundation, and for this step you can use liquid foundation, cushion foundation or any BB or CC cream you have. Here I am using Innisfree Longwear Cushion in shade 23 True Beige. This foundation is really easy to use, and it has SPF 50+, PA++++, and the best thing about this foundation is it doesn't move throughout the day. The shade is little bit light for me, but it gives me like really brighter look, and the coverage of this foundation is pretty good. And this foundation is travel friendly, so you can throw this in your purse and you can use this for your touch-ups. And the best thing about this foundation that it has SPF+, this is a foundation, so this is like a 2-in-1 product and really easy to use. Innisfree foundation is easily available in India. You can get this from online store or from any Innisfree store. Step 3 is setting powder. Setting your makeup is really important in summers, and this step will set and lock everything in place, and your makeup will not move throughout the day. For this step you can use any loose or compact powder for this. Here I'm using Innisfree No Sebum Mineral Powder. Let's go on to our eyebrows. Here I'm lightly filling in my eyebrows to give them nice shape, and I'm filling any bald spot I have in my eyebrows. For this step, I'm using Innisfree Always New Auto Liner in dark brown shade. After filling in my eyebrows, I'm using Q-tip to soften any harsh line I made and to give softened look. Don't use any dark black or black color shade. Just don't overdo this step and keep it simple and soft. Next step is eyeshadow. Now for this step you can use any orange or peachy shade eyeshadow you have. I'm using this orange shimmery eyeshadow on my eyelids by the brand Epew. It's a duo eyeshadow. Now first I'm going to use this matte nude eyeshadow on my eyelid for my base, and after this I'm using this shimmery orange eyeshadow really close to my upper lash line, and then blending this in with my fluffy eyeshadow brush. After that, I'm using Shame eyeshadow on my lower lash line all the way to the end, and then connecting to my upper lash line. This eye makeup will give you really young, bright and cute look. Next step is eyeliner. For this step, you can use any liquid or gel liner you have. Here, I'm using L'Oreal Black Gel Liner. First, you need to start with lining your upper waterline and then draw a really thin line above and drag this little bit outside. Don't go crazy with eyeliner, just draw a really thin line, and I'm using really thin liner brush to get this really thin liner look and to use this onto my upper waterline. I am using concealer after my eye makeup because this will give me natural aerosol effect, and after all this makeup I want to highlight my under eye area, forehead, chin and my bridge of nose. For concealer, I am using Etude House Big Cover Concealer Tip Concealer in the shade beige, and for blending I am using same Innisfree puff for this. And after blending all this concealer, don't forget to use your setting powder to set your concealer because this is really important. And I use same Innisfree No Sebum Mineral Powder to set my concealer. Step 8 is mascara, but before using mascara, I'm going to use eyelash curler to curl up my lashes, and after that I'm using It's a Skin Baby Face Petite Mascara. This is in black color, and first I'm going to coat my lashes with this mascara for about 3-4 times, and I will use same mascara to coat my lower lashes, and mascara will make your eyes look bigger, beautiful and cute. Step 9 is blusher, and blusher is really important. For this step, I'm going to use Innisfree Petal Blusher in the shade 01. Now, this is not a nail paint, but this is a blusher in nail paint bottle, which is really cute and interesting packaging for blusher. This is a liquid blusher, and this will give you really glowy look. First, I'm going to put this on the back of my hand, and after this, I'm going to use sponge to transfer on my cheek. Last step is lip tint, and for this I'm going to use really famous Peripera Airy Ink Velvet in the shade 02 Pretty Orange Pink, and like name, this is a pink and orange lip tint, and this is really opaque. And first I'm going to put this lip tint on all over my lips. After this I'm going to use tissue paper to remove excess, and then I am going to use same Innisfree puff for gradient lips. I included step 11, but this is completely optional step. I just wanted to use highlighter for more glow. For this step, you can use any powder or liquid highlighter. Here I'm using cushion highlighter, and this is really good for natural glow, but I am using brush for this for really soft look, and I am using this highlighter like everywhere on my face, and I don't know why, but I always go crazy with highlighters. So yeah guys, this is it. This is my complete Korean makeup look after all these steps. Let me know what you think about this, and please like this video if you found this video really helpful, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to see more Korean stuff on my channel, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, take care of yourself. Have a nice day. Bye bye.